ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ नमो भगवते वैवस्वताय प्रत्यवे ब्रह्म विद्याचार्याय नचिकेतसे च
ओम
यू कैन रिपीट आफ्टर मी नाउ न नरेण वरेण प्रोक्त एषः
न नरेण वरेण प्रोक्त एषः
सुविज्ञेयो बहुधा चिन्त्यमानः
सुविज्ञेयो बहुधा चिन्त्यमानः
अनन्य प्रोक्ते गतिरत्र नास्ति
अनन्य प्रोक्ते गतिरत्र नास्ति
अणीयान् ह्यतर्क्यमनुप्रमाणात् नैषा तर्केन मतिरापणेया प्रोक्तान्येनैव सुज्ञानाय प्रेष्ठ या त्वमापः सत्यधृतिर्भतासि त्वाद्रङ्नो भूयान्नचिकेतः पृष्टा जानाम्यघं शेवधिरित्य नित्यम् न ह्यध्रुवैः प्राप्यते हि ध्रुवं तत्
Nahya dhruvaihi prapyate dhruvam tat.
Tato maya nachiketaschitognihi.
Tato maya nachiketaschitognihi.
Anityaihi dravyaihi praptavan asmi nityam.
Anityaihi dravyaihi praptavan asmi nityam.
This is the last mantra. We were reading in the last class. Janamyakam shevadiritya nityam nakshadravaiv prapyatehi dravam tat. Tato maya nachiketas chitognihi anityehi dravyehi praptava asmi ityam iti. Janami. Aham janami. Aham. Kim janami? Yamadharma Raja says, I know. I know what? I know. Shevadihi. Shevadihi is nidihi. Shevadihi is nidihi, which is karmapala. Karmapala is the nidhi, is the treasure, which I know to be adhruvam anityam iti. I know that karmapala is anityam. Why does he say this? Here, Yamadharma Raja, he compares himself with Nachiketa. Yamadharma Raja, he talks about himself. Yamadharma Raja, in his previous Janma, when he was a Manushya in the Bhuloka, he performed a lot of Yajna and Upasana. Particularly, he performed this Nachiketa, Nachiketa Agnihi, the ritual, which was named after Nachiketa. Nachiketa Agnihi. By that ritual, a person attains Brahmaloka, Brahmaloka Prapti, that we saw. That Agni, that ritual, when it is performed along with Upasana, it gives Brahmaloka, Brahmaloka Prapti. And once you go to Brahmaloka, you gain Jnanam from Brahmaji and you get Mukti. That Mukti is called Krama Mukti. So Yamadharma Raja, he performed this Agni, and by the Karmapala of his ritual, now he has attained the position of Yamadharma, that position of Yamadharma Padavi. He becomes the Raja of that position, designation of controlling the human beings, controlling all the beings. That is a padavi. And after accomplishing this padavi, this position, this Brahmaloka Prapti, then he gained Jnanam. The same Jnanam would have been gained in the Bhuloka itself, provided if he had enough Vairagya, Viveka Vairagya Shamadhi Shakka Sampatti, if we add the Bhuloka itself, you would have gained Atmajnanam and Moksha directly. Instead of doing all the rituals and the Upasanas, then going to Brahmaloka and then attaining Brahmajnanam, directly could have been attained in the Bhuloka itself. Therefore, Yamadharma Raja, he compares himself with Nachiketa. Here he says, Nachiketa's is Vairagya. It's Vairagya to Anitya. It is so superior, it is extremely great compared to myself, he says. Nachiketa, he had a firm conclusion that that the any happiness which you gain in the Bhuloka by performing, either in the Bhuloka or in the other loka, which you gain by performing upasana, they are all going to be anityam. It will not give you ultimately what you want. Moksham, atmajnanam. Moksha is only by atmajnanam. Without that, it is not possible. Nachiketa knows that. That is why he asked the question, Eyam prete vichikitsa manushye. Asti tyeke nasti iti cha eke iti. The 20th mantra of the first section as a third bone. Even though Yamadharmaraja tempted Nachiketa with a lot of offerings, he just shunned all those and he wanted only that boon. That shows us Vairagyam and Viveka Vairagyam. Therefore, Yamadharmaraja was so pleased. Therefore, Punarapi Tushtaha Yamadharmarajaha Aha Mrityuhu Prasannaha. Madharmaraja Prasannaha Abhavat. He became so happy and therefore he says, Janami Akam Shevadihi Shevadihi Iti Anityam. Akam Anityam Iti Shevadihi Anityam Iti Akam Janami. I know that Shevadi. Shevadi is Nidhi. Shevadi is Nidhi. Treasure. Nidhi means treasure. What is the treasure? Karmapala. Karmapala is the nidhi, is the treasure. That is anityam iti aham janami. I know that to be anityam. We have seen the meaning of this mantra. You have to read the Bhashyam. Before we read the Bhashyam, just I'll give a simple meaning of the mantra again. Then, adruvaihi dhruvam na prapyate. Adruvaihi means astiram, that which is not permanent, adruvam. Dhruvam is permanent, stira. So, by adruva, impermanent things, you cannot gain permanent things. All karma rituals, they are limited. Therefore, they are anitya. And therefore, what you gain by the karma pala, what you gain by karma, that is a karma pala going to be agama vayinaha. It comes and goes. It comes at a particular time, at a particular period in life. And then once the karma pala is enjoyed, it is going to be exhausted. Gaining punyam going to Surgaloka, once the karma pala, punya is exhausted in the Sorgaloka, Kshine Punya Matya Loka Mishanti. One has to come down again and start. Therefore, Adruvaihi Dhruvam Na Prapyate. Tataha Maya Nachiketaha Agnihi Chitaha. Therefore, Chitaha. I gathered the Karvapala. I gathered the Pala by performing the Nachiketa Agnihi, Nachiketa ritual. The ritual which is performed along with upasana. I performed. And what happened to me then? Anityaihi dravyaihi nityam praptavan asmi. Anityaihi dravyaihi. By anitya dravya. Dravya is materials. Karma. The karma, the rituals which is a karma, which involves all the materials, they are all anitya. They are limited. So the yajna which is accomplished with a lot of materials and therefore and those the yajna and the materials, everything being limited, therefore the karma pala, the result of that karma, which is also going to be limited. Therefore, praptavan asmi, I attained those anitya karma pala. Here nityam is that. Nityam praptavan asmi in the moolam. But here that word nityam should not be taken as nityam means permanent. Only apekshika nityam. Relatively permanent. Because svargaloka prapti, we say nityam. You you get into Swarga Loka forever. Forever means it is, the time period is so long. Therefore, we say Nityam. It is not Nityam means it will be permanent forever. No, relatively permanent. So the Nityam, the word should be interpreted as Apekshika Nityatvam, not Atyanta Nityatvam. Bhagavad himself will say that. Here only we have to apply our thinking, the logic. Karma being limited, karma pala also going to be limited. Karma is adhruvam, karma pala cannot be dhruvam. Therefore, if Yamadharmaraja says, anityehi dravyehi nityam praptavan, then we have to apply our thinking and the word nityam should be interpreted properly. By anitya dravya agam nityam praptavan, by anitya dravya materials, the karma, by anitya karma, I have gained nityam means, how can limited karma can give you unlimited karma pala? It is not possible. It is against logic. So therefore, the word nityam should be interpreted properly. Here we have to apply our thinking. We cannot take literally the word nityam. That is why we need to do the analysis. Mimamsa is required. Okay, now Divashyam. You can read, you can repeat after me.
Janam yagam shevadihi nidihi.
Janam yagam shevadihi nidihi.
Karma pala lakshanaha nidihi iva prarthyate iti.
Karma pala lakshanaha nidihi iva prarthyate iti.
Okay. We'll see the meaning now. Janam yaham. Janam yaham is janami aham. You know the sandhi now. Janami aham, janam yaham. Yan sandhi. Shevadihi. What is the meaning of shevadihi? Shevadihi is nidihi. Shevadihi is equal to nidihi. Bhagavad Pada gives the meaning of the word shevadihi is nidihi. So nidhihi janami. Nidhihi is what? Treasure. I know the treasure. What does it mean? I know the treasure. What is the treasure? The word treasure also has to be interpreted. Shevadihi means nidhihi. And what is nidhihi? Nidhihi is karma pala lakshanaha nidhihi. What is nidhi? The nidhi which is the form of the result of action. Karma pala lakshanaha nidhihi. Iva praptyate iti, that is sought after. Praptyate iti. Karmapala is called shevadihi, nidihi, treasure. Why karmapala is called nidihi, treasure? Here, the word nidihi is interpreted as karmapala, karmapala lakshanaha, the secondary. In the secondary sense, nidihi meaning treasure. Karmapala is also a treasure. Nidhi is what sought after. Nidhi meaning treasure. So it is what a person seeks. Nidhi. It is something which is sought after. Similarly, karma pala is what sought after by human beings. Since both are sought after, therefore, since they have the same quality of seeking after, therefore, nidhihi is called karma pala. Like we say, Devadattaha Simnaha. Devadattaha Simnaha, we can say. Devadatta, the person with the name Devadatta, is like a lion. What does it mean? Devadatta, the person is like a lion. Lion has got a strong body and it has got a huge mane. And it, lion doesn't speak, it has a short teeth. Whereas Devadatta is a human being and he doesn't have a long mane like a lion. Then how can you call? By physical comparison, you cannot call a Devadatta to be a lion. Then how do you compare Devadatta with the lion? Because of his strength. He has got a strong body, he is fearless. So certain qualities are of the Devadatta as compared to the lion, and therefore we say Devadatta Simha. He is like a lion. So we cannot literally understand Devadatta is a lion. Devadatta is the name of the, either Devadatta is the name of the lion, or the person Devadatta is an animal. He is a human being, but he is an animal. We cannot take that way. He is so strong, he has got these certain the qualities, brave qualities of the lion. Therefore, Devadatta Simha. It is similarly here also. We cannot take the Samanya Guna. We have to take the secondary Guna. Gauna Prayoga. Therefore, here, Nidhihi is what sought after. Similarly, Karmapala is what a human being seeks by karma. Therefore, Nidhihi is Karmapala Lakshanaha. Iti Bhavatpada gives the meaning of the word Nidhihi. Nidhihi Prartyate. Prakrishena Artyate, that which is sought after. Therefore, Nidhihi is called Karmapala. So, Aham Janani, Nidhihi, Karmapala Lakshanaha. What? Next line. Aso Anityam Anityaha Iti Janami.
Aso Anityam Iti Janami.
The word Nitya. It is Nityaha. It must be Nityaha. It cannot be Nityam. But in the mantra, it is given Anityam. In the mantra, Anityam is given. Therefore, Asau refers to Karmapala. Karmapala, Anityam. Anityaha iti Janami. Anityam is Chandasam. Shastram. Upanishad uses the word Anityam, but Anityam is equal to Anityaha. Aso Anityam, Anityam is equal to Anityaha iti Janami, Aham Janami. Anityaha, what is Anityaha? Karmapala is Anityaha iti Aham Janami. That Nidhi, which is Karmapala Lakshanaha, the Nidhi, which is in the a form of result of karma, it is anityaha, it is not permanent. Iti aham janami. Then the next line, nahi yasmat,
nahi yasmat
anityehi adruvaihi. Nityam Dhruvam Tat Prapyate.
Nityam Dhruvam Tat Prapyate.
Paramatma Khyaha.
Paramatma Khyaha.
Shevadihi.
Shevadihi.
There we can stop. We have to put, yeah, stop there. Shevadihi. You will see the meaning now. Nahi kismat anityegi adruvaihi nityam dhruvam tat prapyate tat paramatma kyaha shevadihi. Nahi, that is there in the mulam. Nakhyadruvai prapyate hi dhruvam tat nahi. Nahi, it is there in the mulam. He here is yasmat. He means it's a particle. It is indeclinable. Yasmat. Yasmat. Yasmat karanat. Because of that. Yasmat. Anityaihi. Anityaihi. Adhruvaihi. Anityaihi. Adhruvaihi. By impermanent. By impermanent means. The means by the impermanent means. Adhruvaihi. Anityaihi. Sadhanaihi. The means are impermanent. With the impermanent means. Nityam dhruvam. Tat prapyate. Nityam, which is permanent, which is dhruvam, stiram, permanent. Dhruvam, stiram, tat prapyate, is attained. Is attained? The na should be connected to the kriyapadam. Na, always the negative particle will come at the beginning of the sentence. We have to connect the na to the kriyapadam. Tat na prapyate. Tat na prapyate. So anityaihi adhruvaihi nityam dhruvam na prapyate. By the impermanent means, the permanent ends are not attained, not possible. Na prapyate. And what is the nidhi here? What is the end? What is the sadhyam? With the impermanent sadhanam, this nitya sadhyam is not achievable. And what is the sadhyam? Paramatkyaha, paramatmakyaha shevadihi. That nidhi, that shevadi, that is karmapala, which is known by the name paramatma. Paramatma is jnanam, moksha. The knowledge of paramatma, which is moksha. The knowledge of paramatma frees oneself from samsara and forever. Only through knowledge, aham brahma asmi, only through that knowledge, one becomes free from samsara. Therefore, that knowledge is not, that knowledge cannot be attained by karma. Moksha cannot be attained by karma. Therefore, that nidhi, paramatma kyaha, that known by the name paramatma, nidhihi, na prapyate, which is dhruvam, that dhruva sadhyam is not achievable by adhruva sadhanam, iti. Then, continuing, next line. Yahatu. Anitya sukhatmakaha. Shevadihi.
Shevadihi.
Sahi.
Sahi.
Sorry, Sayeva.
Sayeva.
Anityaihi dravyaihi prapyate.
Anityaihi dravyaihi prapyate.
Okay. Yastu anitya sukhatmakaha shevadihi sayeva anityaihi dravyaihi prapyate. Anityaihi dravyaihi prapyate iti. So, yastu, yaha tu. Yaha tu anitya, anitya sukhatmakaha. Sukhatmakaha shevadihi sayeva anityaihi dravyaihi prapyate. Prapyate, attained. Prapyate, attained. What is attained? Shevadihi. The treasure which is in the form of, which is the form of impermanent. Impermanent. Anityaihi. Anityaihi dravyaihi. Which is impermanent. Na prapyate. that which is not achieved by impermanent things. Anityehi dravyehi is to at shevadi. Shevadi here is anitya sukhatmakaha. That is anitya sukhatmakaha in the form of impermanent happiness. Anitya sukhatmakaha. That is in the form of impermanent happiness. Yaha tu anitya sukhatmaka shevadihi sayeva anityehi dravyehi prapyate. It means by the anitya dravya, what you gain is only anitya. Anitya ends, anitya results. By anitya dravya, by finite things, what you gain is only finite ends. By impermanent things, what you gain only is impermanent. So anityehi dravyehi kim prapyate anityaha sukhatmakaha shevadihi. That shevadi, the treasure, which is in the form of impermanent sukham. Sukhatmakaha, that which is in the form of impermanent sukham. So by the impermanent materials, you gain impermanent ends, which are in the form of impermanent happiness. So here, Bhagavad Pada, he explains the word, the part of the mula, nagyadvaihi prapyatehi dhruvam tat, that is explained. By anitya ends, anitya means you gain only anitya ends. So sukham, permanent sukham is not possible by anitya means. Then continuing, he yataha.
Nirvartitaha.
Okay. He yataha tataha tasmat maya janata api nityam anitya sadhanehi na prapyate iti nachiketa stita agnihi anitya dravyehi pashvadibhihi swarga sukha sadhana bhutaha agnihi nirvartitaha ityartha. So here it says he is because of this both said reason anityehi dravyehi nityam na prapyate, since because of that tataha, therefore tataha is there in the mulam, tataha maya nachiketa agnihi, it is there in the mulam. So tataha, tataha is equal to tasmat, therefore, because it is so, therefore, he, yataha, tataha, therefore, janata api, maya janata api, even though known by me, what is known? Nityam, anitya sadhanehi na plapyate, you have to see. That is a statement of Yamadharmaraja. So therefore, which is in quote. நித்யம் அனித்ய சாதனைக்கு ந பிராப்யதே இதி ஜானதா அபி மயா தஸ்மாத் மயா ஜானதா அபி Therefore, known by me. What is known by me? What is known to me? Nityam anitya sadhanehi na prapyate. Nitya vastu is not attainable by anitya vastu. Iti janatapi, knowing very well, nachiketaha chitaha agnihi. The fire ritual, nachiketa, Anityehi dravyehi pashvadivihi svargasadana bhutaha. That ritual which is in the form of svargasadana, svargasukasadana, which is the means for the gaining the svargasuka, the means for gaining the svargasuka. That nachiketa agni, that ritual which is in the form of, which is in the form of the means for gaining the svargasukha, how? By performing the ritual, how? Anityehi dravyehi pashvadibhi. The rituals, which involves the ingredients, anityehi dravyehi, anitya dravya, the materials which are not nitya, pashvadibhi. What are those materials? Pashvadibhi, pashu, etc. Pashu, etc. by that. So here, the word he, it is there in the Moolam. The he is equal to yataha. Since this is so, because of what? By anitya, one cannot attain nitya. Therefore, tataha, yasmat, therefore, tataha, tasmat, maya janata api, knowing very well. Anityam, Nityam anitya sadhanehi na prapyate iti janata api. I did this. Achiketa agnehi. Nirvartitaha means I performed. This was achieved. This ritual was performed. This ritual was performed knowing very well the fact by anitya vastu nitya cannot be gained. And this, the result of this ritual being the svarga loka prapti, the means for attaining the Svargaloka Prapti is this ritual. And Nirvartitaha, that ritual was accomplished by me. How? Pashvadivihi, Pashu, etc. Pashu, etc., which are required for the ritual. Pashu means Pashu means in general animals. So the products of the cow, Gritam is ajyam is offered in the fire. So those are all prepared from the cow's milk. Therefore, all those ingredients by that, this ritual is accomplished by me. Ityartaha. Here, the word Nachiketa Agnihi. Nachiketa is the name of the ritual which Yamagarma Raja taught to Nachiketa. Before Yamadharma and Nachiketa Samvada, the ritual was not named by Nachiketa Agnihi. But here, since the ritual was named after the student Nachiketa, Yamadharma Raja himself, he refers to the ritual as Nachiketa Agnihi. I performed that ritual. Therefore, what happened after that?
Tena aham.
Adhikara pannaha.
Yamyam sthanam svargakhyam.
Nityam apekshikam praptavan asmi.
Tena
is Nachiketa Chitagdina. By that Nachiketa ritual, Tena what? Agam Adhikara Pannaha. By that ritual, Adhikara is the qualification. Apannaha attained. By that ritual, I attain the adhikara, 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 adhikaritvam. I attained praptavan asmi. Adhikara, adhikara apannaha, praptavan asmi. I have attained. Having attained the qualification, adhikara, the qualification to be attained, and by that, aham praptavan asmi, I attained. What? Nityam, the nityam is there in the mulam. Aham nityam praptavan asmi. Praptavan asmi nityam, which is there in the mulam. Aham nityam praptavan asmi. What is that nityam? Yamyam sthanam svargakyam nityam. And Bhagavad Pada, he adds the word, very important, apekshikam. Apekshikam nityam yamyam sthanam svargakyam praptavan asmi. What is that nityam? The nityam is not atyantika nityam, it is apekshikam. It is relatively permanent. Relative nityatvam. Apekshikam nityam. And what is that? Yamyam sthanam. Yamyam. What is yamyam? Yamasya idam. Yama is a padavi. It's a designation. The position of yama. So, yamasya tasya idam yamyam. That position of yama dharma, that padavi, that is yamyam. That is sthanam. That is a designation. The place, the position, which is the position of yama dharma padavi, which is apekshikam, apekshika nityatvam, is praptavan asmi, attained. Svargakyam. Svargakyam is this position is not related to the bhuloka, it is heavenly. So that heavenly position of yama dharma padavi attained by me. That yama is a position, like Indra is a position, the position of this yama is actually means yamayati niyachati iti yamaha, the one who controls everything is called yama. It is a position. So that position, which is svargakyam, that heavenly position, why it is svargakyam? Because compared to human span in the bhuloka, it is going to be a long one. Therefore, svargakyam nityam, that heavenly nityam position, praptavan asmi, attained. And nityam is qualified apekshikam, by the word apekshikam nityam. So that nityam is relatively nityam compared to the lifespan of human beings in the bhuloka. Here this position is going to be nityam. Therefore, apekshikam nityam, the relatively permanent. The nityam is only in terms of comparison, comparing with the other. Other is human beings. Human beings have got a definite short span compared to the span of this enjoying the position in the Swarga, heavenly position. Swarga akyam yamyam sthanam. Therefore, I attain that by performing the Nachiketa Agni. Then comes the next mantra. So here, Yamadharma Raja still he continues the praise of his student Nachiketa. He glorifies Nachiketa. Nachiketa, he rejected even the Brahmaloka Prapti Sadhana. Nachiketa would have done this Achiketa Agni, by which you go to Brahmaloka and enjoy all the pleasures. You can even attain the position of Hiranyagarbha, that Brahmaji's position. That is the highest position possible in the Jagat, in the relative universe. That is the highest position possible. But Achiketa rejected. He wanted only Jnana. Therefore, Madhurama Raja, he wanted to praise the Vairagyam, that objectivity, that commitment of the student Nachiketa. Therefore, he glorifies him. In the next shloka, Kamasyaptim jagatav pratishtham.
Kamasyaptim jagatav
Kratoranantya mabhagasya param. Kratoho anantyam abhayasya param.
Kratoho anantyam abhayasya param.
Stoma mahadurbhagyam pratishtham drishtva.
Stoma mahadurbhagyam pratishtham drishtva.
Dhritya dhiro nachiketo tyasrakshi.
Dhritya dhiro nachiketo tyasrakshi.
Nachiketostyastrakshi. Nachiketostyastrakshi. Okay. So here. Kamasyaptim jagatah patishtam kratorantyam abhayasya param. Stoma mahadurbhagyam pratishtam drishtva. Dhrityadhiro nachiketo tisrakshihi. It is only srakshihi, not strakshihi. We saw that the word before also it came. It is from the dhatu srajdhatu. Therefore, it must be srakshihi, not strakshihi. Nachiketo tisrakshihi. It came before also. We saw the word astrakshihi. Anyway, so here, kamasya, aptim, give the individual words. Kamasya, aptim, jagataha, pratishtham, kratoho, antyam, abhagasya, param, stoma, mahat, urugayam, pratishtham, trishtva, Dhritya dhiraha nachiketaha atyasrakshihi. Atyasrakshihi. Here the word nachiketa. Nachiketaha is a nachiketa. It could be sambodhana. Here it could be sambodhana. Hey nachiketa. Nachiketaha. Nachiketas, you know, it's a sakaranta shabda. So, he nachiketaha, or nachiketas. He nachiketaha. The sentence is astrakshihi, that is the kriyapadam. Astrakshihi. It is astrakshi, ati astrakshihi, atyastrakshihi. Ati is there, the upasarga, ati is there. Astrakshihi, the kriyapadam, with the upasarga, ati. So, Atyasrakshihi. Atyasrakshihi is the kriyapadam. Tvam, you. In Nachiketaha, dhritya, the word Nachiketaha, Asyasrakshi. Tvam, Asyasrakshihi, Madhyama Purusha, Ekavachan. Atyasrakshihi. It means you discarded, you rejected. So therefore, Tvam, Atyasrakshihi. In Nachiketa, Atyastrakshihi. That is a sentence. That is a basic sentence. But what did Nachiketa reject? The remaining words in the shloka, in the mantra, it says that. Drishtva, the word drishtva is that. Drishtva he Nachiketaha from Atyastrakshihi. Having seen, you discarded, you rejected. What did he see? Kamasyaptim jagatav pratishtam. Kamasyaptim jagatav. Kamasyaptim jagatav pratishtam. Kratoranantyam abhayasya param. Stomam akrit urgayam pratishtam. Drishtva. Everything is in dvitiya bhakti. So having seen all this, hey Nachiketa, you dismissed, you discarded. If you discarded this, So, Urugayam, Urugayam, Stoma Magatu, Patrishtam, Stoma Mahadurgayam, Patrishtam, Patrishtam, the word here, Stoma Mahadurgayam, Patrishtam, the word Patrishtam here refers to the Hiranyagarbha. It refers to the Hiranyagarbha. Stomaha Durgayam Pratishtam. Hiranyagarbha is what? Samashti Sukshma Prapancha. Samashti Sukshma Prapancha Atma. It's called Hiranyagarbha. Samashti Sukshma Prapancha Ishvara. Ishvara, who is Samashti Sukshma Prapancha? We saw in Tattvabodha, in individual it is called Prajñaha, Tejasaha, Vishvaha iti. Similarly, Samashti Sukshma Prapancha Chaitanyam is called Hiranyagarbha. So, in other words, we can call it as Brahmaji. It's a position. It's a position. And that Patrishtam, that position is Stovam, Stoma Mahat Urgayam. Stoma Mahat Urgayam, that is, it is vast. It is vast and it is glorious. Glorious position, that Hiranyagarbha position, the Brahmaji position is glorious. So, that position, which is what? Kamas Yaptim, which is the end of the kamas. What else could be the greatest desire other than this, other than occupying the position of Hiranyagarbha, the Brahmaji's position? There cannot be any more desire than this. That is the culmination. If at all a desire can culminate in a particular thing, that could be only the Hiranyagarbha Padavi. Like, what is the greatest designation in this in the loka, now in this bhuloka? The presidentship of America, that is the greatest position. There cannot be more than that. Being the president of US, that is the greatest position. Similarly, in this jagat, the greatest position above which there is no other position, and that is the culmination of all the desires. It is this Hiranyagarbha position, this Brahmaji's position. Therefore, Kamasya Aptim, Kamasya Aptim, the limit of the culmination of all the culmination of the ultimate, the pleasure, the Sukham, Kama, is that position. And that is Jagatav Pratishtam, that which is the Pratishta, which is the support of this Jagat. Hiranyagarbha is the support, is the cause of this Jagat. Therefore, it is a support of this Jagat, this universe, entire universe. Jagatav Pratishtam. And it is Anantyam Kratoho. Kratoho Anantyam. Krato means ritual. Yajna. Krato means ritual. Anantyam means Antyam Na Vidyate. It is unlimited. Kratoho Anantyam, which is the result of the Anantya, unlimited Kratu, Yajna, meditation, Upasana. Kratu means Yajna. Here we can take the meaning of Upasana, because we are talking about this Hiranyagarbha Padavi, that Brahmaji's Padavi, that is attainable by Upasana, meditation. Therefore, Kratoho Anantyam, Anantyam, unlimited, which is the result of the unlimited, which is the infinite result of Upasana, meditation. That Hiranyagarbha Padavi, which is the result of, the result is infinite, which is the infinite result of meditation. Anantyam, Anantyam Kratu, or it can be the result of Anantya Kratu, the meditation, attainable by the Upasana, which is Anantya. And Abhayasya Param. Abhayasya Param. Abhaya means Nabhaya. Bhaya means fear. Abhaya is fearless. So param. Param is the highest state of fearlessness. The highest state of fearlessness. So that is what? That is the state of Hiranyagarbha. So therefore, Nachiketa, having seen the extensive, the glorious Hiranyagarbha, which is the highest, the pleasure one can obtain, and which is the support, Jagatav Pratishtam, which is the support of the universe, and which is gained by the Anantya Kratu, the meditations, which are Anantya, endless, which is the result of endless meditation, and which is the Abhayasya Param, the highest state of fearlessness. O Nachiketa, Tom Atyastrakshi, you just dismissed, rejected. So therefore, having given even that, you discarded that. Therefore, how much vairagya you will be having? That shows me. Nachiketa had tremendous vairagya. Even you discarded the highest position which a person can obtain, that Hiranyagarbha, which is the position equivalent to Brahmaji. Brahmaji, you will do the job of that designation for the whole cycle, for the whole one full cycle. You will be presiding over the creation, and after that you will get mukti, you will get moksha. But Nachiketa, you just dismissed that and you wanted mukti here and now. Therefore, Madhurma Raja, he praises, even you discarded the Hiranyagarbha Padavi. Okay. Now, you will read the Bhashyam. And before reading the Bhashyam, this word, Anantyasya, the word Anantyasya, it is Chandasam. The word is Kratoho Anantyasya. It is Chandasam. It is a usage of the Shastram. Anantasya Bhavam Anantam. Anantasya Bhavam, it should be Anantam. And there Anantyam must be there. But Anantyam is there. So it is the Vedic usage, Chandasam. Veda can use. Okay. So on the word Urugayam, Urugayam means extensive, vast. Stoma Magath means glorious. It is glorious. Okay. You will read the Vashyam. Tvamtu.
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 Kamasyaptim.
Kamasyaptim.
Atraivehaiva.
Atraivehaiva.
It's a good exercise. Sandhi, you can split. Atra. Then atra
iva,
iva,
atra plus iva,
atra eva, not iva, atra eva, iha eva, atra eva, iha eva. So atra iva, iva. Okay, sarve kamaha,
sarve kamaha,
parisamaptaha,
parisamaptaha.
Okay. We'll read this. That should be danda. Tvam tu. Tvam tu. Tvam is understood. Atyasrakshihi is there. Therefore, tvam tu. Whereas you, kamasyaptim. Apti. Apyate iti. That which is attained. What? Kamasya. Highest limit of kama. Sukha. Which is attained. Kamasyaptim. Here, that in Hiranyagarbha only, all the pleasures, they culminate, they find their culmination in that Hiranyagarbha. Therefore, kamasyaptim. From to, whereas you, atyastrakshi, you give up, you discarded. What? Kamasyaptim, samaptim, which is the highest limit of pleasure. Atra eva, ikha eva. Here only, where in this, sarve kamaha parisamaptaha. all the kamas here only it culminate. It means they find the highest limit here only. It is the pinnacle of all the pleasures. And tvam atisrakshi, you just discarded. Continuing, jagataha. Sadhya, okay, I will read individually. Sa adhyatma. Adhibhuta. Adhideva dehe. Adhyatma adhibhuta adhideva. Three words are that. Sadhyatma adhibhuta adhideva dehe. Okay. Pratishtam.
Ashrayam.
Sarvatmakatvat. The word kamasyaptim was described. Now, Jagatap Pratishtam is described by the Acharya. We will see what it is. Okay. Jagataha Pratishtam. Pratishtam is ashrayam, support. Ashraya is shelter, support. Pratishtam of the jagat, of the entire universe. What is that? And jagataha is described. What is jagataha? Jagataha pratishtam. Okay. Pratishtam word is ashrayam. Bhagavad Pada gives pratishtam is equal to ashrayam. Okay. And what is jagataha? It is described by the word sadhyatmadi bhuthadhi dhivadehe. That is, sa adhyatma adibhuta adidevadehe. Sa yar saha. Saha adhyatma. Saha tritiya. Sa is that. That is along with, in the meaning, along with. Along with what? Adhyatma, adibhuta, and adideva. What is adhyatma? Adhyatma refers to the individual. Adhyatma refers to the individual beings. Here, the individual beings means we have to take into account the sense organs, indriyani, prana and manas, adhyatma. Adhibhuta, it refers to the sense objects. By adhyatma refers to the sense organs, prana and the manas. Sense organs means manas also will be there. Sense organs function only backup by the mind and prana also is there. So all the indriyani. All the indriyani, that is adhyatma. Adhibhuta refers to the sense objects, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. So all the sense objects are available for sense perception by the sense organs. So adhibhutam refers to the objects which are available in the external world, jagat. They are the product of elements and elementals. The product of elements, panchabhuta, and which is born of panchabhuta. The panchabhuta decombine in different form ways and elementals are formed. From the elements, elementals are formed. So, adhibhutam refers to the sense objects, which is in the form of elements and elementals. And each adhibhutam, they have got what? Adhideva. We have read in the Tattva Bodha. That is why Tattva Bodha is important. Direction has got presiding deity. And sense organs, each sense organs has got presiding deities. Jnanendriyani has got presiding deities. Karmendriyani has got presiding deities. Chakshushaha, Suryaha, and all we have read. And Padoha, Vishnuhu, and all. So, the presiding deities of the Adhibhuta. For example, if you take the sense organ, Shrotra, ear, Karna. Shrotra, if you take the sense organ, and what is the adhibhutam for that? What is the adhibhutam? Shabda. Shabda is the adhibhutam. And shabda refers to this, the what is the cause? The shabda is because of the akasha. And what is the presiding deity? Digdevata. Digdevata is the presiding deity of shabda. Shabda is because of the space. Shabda is because of the space, and then the Digdevata is the presiding deity. Therefore, This is just an example, taking the sense organs, shrotra. Similarly, for other sense organs, we have to understand. Therefore, taking the adhyatma, adhibhuta, and adhideva, all these three are nothing but the jagat, entire jagat. And the entire jagat, which has the ashrayam, the pratishtha, in what? In Hiranyagarbha. Therefore, the Hiranyagarbha is what? In the form of everything, sarvatmakatvat. That Hiranyagarbha, which is along with the adhyatma, adhibhuta, adhideva, and sarvatmakatvat, sarm atma yasya, which is in the form of everything. At Hiranyagarbha, sarvam atma yasya, sarvatmakatvat, sarvatmakaha Hiranyagarbha. Therefore, jagatah patishtam, drishtva, having seen that. Who? Nachiketa. So, the jagatah patishtam is described. Then, the next part. Kratoho palam. And before that, one more thing here. Sarvatmakatvat, that which is in the form of everything. What is the cause of this jagat? Jagat is stula. And what is the cause for the stula prapancha? Sukshma prapancha is the cause. So, the stula is the product and sukshma is the cause. So, the product will be pervaded by what? The cause. The product will be pervaded by the cause. So, the karanam for stula prapancha is sukshma prapancha. And sukshma prapancha, abhimani, atma, chaitanyam is Hiranyagarbha. Therefore, Hiranyagarbha will pervade the entire jagat. Like a pot is a product. And what is the cause of the pot? Clay. So, we can say the clay pervades the pot. Similarly, Hiranyagarbha pervades the entire universe. Therefore, this whole jagat has got the pratishtha and ashraya in that Hiranyagarbha. And Hiranyagarbha, which is in the form of everything, sarvatmakatvat, Hiranyagarbha, drishtva. So, pratishtam, it is in Dvitiya Vibhakti, jagat of pratishtam, and katoho abhayasya param, everything in Dvitiya Vibhakti, having seen that, Nachiketa rejected. That is the meaning. Now, continuing, kratoho, palam.
Hiranyagarbham.
Padam.
Anantyam.
Anantyam. Here, Anantyam. Anantyam is Bhagavad Gita gives the correct the word Anantyam. It doesn't mean that Upanishad uses wrongly. Upanishad can always use. That is allowed. Chandasam. Anantyam is equal to Anantyam. It's tadita. Anantyasya bhavaha Anantyam. The word should be Anantyam. Anantyam is endless. Endless. Kratoho palam. The result of the kratu. Kratu is upasana. So therefore, upasanayaha palam. The result of the meditation. The Brahma loka prapti and this the Brahmaji's position, it is obtainable only by upasana, along with karma. Karma and upasana is there. Upasana must be there. Therefore, kratuhu refers to the meditation upasana. So that Hiranyagarbhasya, Hiranyagarbha padam, which is the result of the upasana, upasana palam, that it is a padavi, it is a padam, it is the position. Therefore, Hiranyagarbham padam. Padam is abode or it can be possession. You can take the meaning as possession. Hiranyagarbham padam. Hiranyagarbham is what? Hiranyagarbhasya idam. Hiranyagarbhasya idam. Hiranyagarbham. It's a tadita. Like Rishehe idam arsham and Anantyasya bhavam anantyam. Similarly, Hiranyagarbhasya idam. Hiranyagarbham. That which is related to Hiranyagarbha. So the position of Hiranyagarbha, it's the result of a particular type of upasana. And which is the result of that is Anantyam. Which is Anantyam. Anantyam. Okay. So Kratoho Anantyam. Then the next one. Abhayasya cha.
Abhayasya cha.
Param param nishtham.
Param.
Here we can follow, I think. Everything is in Vidya Vibhakti. Abhayasya Param, which is Param Nishtham. Abhayasya. Abhayasya means fearless. Fearless. Abhayasya Param. Param, param is Param Nishtham. Highest limit. This means that is highest position. You are the boss of the entire Jagat. There is no second thing to you. So there is no one to fear. You don't have to be afraid of anyone. No one is there to cause you fear. And therefore, abhayasya. Therefore, abhayasya. Dutiyahana vidyate. You are the boss. You are the, that's the highest position. You have total say over the jagat. Therefore, you enjoy the ultimate rights, privilege. Therefore, abhayasya param, param nishtam. Since there is no fear, therefore, and it is going to be long, therefore, there is no fear of to be replaced by anybody immediately. Therefore, it is abhayasya param nishtam, the highest limit of fearlessness. It is also relative. We cannot take it absolutely, because at the end of kalpa, that position also, somebody will come and occupy the position. The position has to be given to someone. That Brahmaji has to give up that position also. He gets mukti. And that position will be occupied by the another person who has done the karma and gained the punya. He will come and occupy the position. Therefore, this padavi, this position also, it is only what you enjoy in this padavi, that Hiranyagarbham padam, that sukham as well as the fearlessness, everything is relative, not atyantika, it's only apyakshika. Apyakshika sukham, apyakshika abhayam also. So this highest relative fearlessness, what is that? Hiranyagarbha padavi, Hiranyagarbham padam, which is Param, Nishtam, Param. The state of highest fearlessness. Then the next one. Stomam.
Stomam.
What is Stomam? Bhagavad Gita gives Stutyam. Stutyam.
Stutyam.
Magat.
Magat.
What is Magat? He is given. Animadi.
Animadi.
Aishwaryadi.
Aishwaryadi.
Aneka guna samhatam.
Aneka guna samhatam.
That is called Magat. Tomam is Tutyam. Magat is Animadi Aishwarya. Animadi must be Anima. Okay, we give Animadi or Anima Aishwarya, both are fine. Anima Aishwaryadi. Aneka guna sambhatam. Then, stomam cha tat magat cha.
Stomam cha tat magat cha.
Niratishayatvat.
Niratishayatvat.
Stomam magat.
Stomam magat.
It must be magat. Stomam magat. That is no magata. Stomam magat. Okay. Stomam. It is there in the molam. Stoma is there in the molam. Stoma is stutyam. Stoma is stutyam. What is stutyam? Stutyam is stuti yogyam. Stutyam is stuti yogyam. Therefore, stomam is stutyam. Stuti yogyam, adorable. And magat is what? Magat is anima aishwarya. Anima adi aishwarya adi aneka guna samhatam. That is endowed with guna, the various, the samhata. Endowed samhata is endowed with various qualities. Guna samhatam, endowed with various qualities. Like what? Animadi, Aishwaryadi, Aneka. Aneka is many, innumerable, many qualities. What? Animadi. Anima is the Siddhi. There are eight Siddhis, Ashta Siddhi, they talked about in our the Shastra. They're all yogic Siddhi attained by the power of yoga. Like Anima, Magima, and those Siddhis. Agima, Anima, and they said that Hanuman had all the Ashta Siddhi. Anima, Magima, Garima, then Lagima, Prapatti, Prakamyam, Pashitvam Iti, Pashitvam Ishitvam Iti, eight Siddhi, Ashta Siddhis are there. Ashta Siddhi and Aishwarya. Aishwarya is Ishwarasya Bhava. Aishwarya. So, and power. Aishwarya is all the wealth, Aishwarya, the power. Power. You can take it as a wealth. Aishwarya. Endowed with everything. Aishwarya. Sakala Aishwarya. So Animadi Aishwarya Adi Aneka Guna Sampratam Magathu. Therefore, that Hiranyagarbha Padavi, which is glorious, which is stutyam, which is stuti yogyam, and it is great. Why it is great? Because it is endowed with Animadi Aishwarya Adi Aneka Guna Sampratam. It is endowed with all these qualities. Ishwarasya Bhavam Aishwarya is that you have got total say over everything and you are endowed with all these Ashta Siddhis, which is Niratishayatva. These qualities, they are Niratishayam. There is nothing equivalent to this. Unsurpassable. Therefore, Stomam cha tat magatcha. Karmadharai samasa. Stomam cha tat magatcha. Stomam agat. Niratishayatva. Stomam agat. Kim that Hiranyagarbha Padavi. Therefore, Stoma Magata, this Stoma Magaduru Gayam Pratishtam. Then, the next one Pratishtam Urugayam.
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 Vistirnam Gatim. Vistirnam Gatim. The word Urgayam is explained further. Vistirnam Gatim. Vistirna. Vistirna is spread, vast, extensive. Vistirna. Urgayam is Vistirnam Gatim. Gatim is the abode, or it could be the goal. Goal. Gati can be the destination also. So here we can take the word Gati. Gati as the destination, the goal. You can take that meaning. So, Urugayam, the goal which is the goal which is Vistina, unlimited, vast. It means unlimited. Urugayam, the goal which is unlimited. Vistina Gatim, the goal which is that Vistina, which is unlimited only in the relative sense. Because this is attained by Upasana. So the goal which is long lasting means relatively. So Vistirnam Gatim. So Urgayam is Vistirnam Gatim, the goal which is long lasting. Then the next one, Pratishtam.
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 Stitim Atmanaha. Anuttamam.
Anuttamam.
Anuttamam api.
Anuttamam api.
Drishtva dhritya.
Drishtva dhritya.
Dhiryena dhiraha.
Dhiryena dhiraha.
Dhimansan.
Dhiman san.
Nachiketaha.
Nachiketaha.
Atyasrakshi.
Atyasrakshi.
Param eva.
Param eva.
Akangshan atisrishtavan asi.
Akankshan Atisrishtavanasi
Sarvam Etat
Sarvam Etat
Samsara Bhoga Jatam
Samsara Bhoga Jatam
Ahobata Anuttama Gunaha Asi
Ahobata Anuttama Gunaha Asi
Asi, not Asti, Asi. So Pratishtam, the last word, Pratishtam. Stomagadurgayam Pratishtam. So that Pratishtam, the word is described here. But what is Pratishtam? Stitim Atmanaha. Atmanaha Stitim Anuttamam. Anuttamam is that which cannot be compared, unsurpassable. And Stiti. Stiti is the station in that position. Stiti. Remaining in that. Atmanaga Siti Pratishtam. So that Atma Siti, that Atmanaga Siti Pratishtam, Drishtva, having seen that in Nachiketa, Dhritya, with firmness, Dhiraha is Bhima, intelligent, Pratyastrakshi, you have given up. So you have given up the state of being in that position. That being in that position, Pratishtam Satim Atmanaha, being in that position, you are given up. You are firmly given up. Being an intelligent person, Dhritya, by Vivekena, you have analyzed and you have given up. Atisrishtavan is that. Atisrishtavan is Atyastrakshihi. Atyastrakshihi is Atisrishtavan. So you have discarded, renounced that position, the glorious position which have been described before. The glorious position which have been described before. The word Pratishtam is interpreted by Bhagavad Pada as Stitim Atmanaha. Atmanaha Stitim. Atmanaha Stitim Anuttamam, which is most excellent. Anuttamam. Uttamaha Navidyate Yasmat. There is nothing better than that. Therefore, Anuttamam Gatim Atmanagastityam Drishtva, having seen Dhritya. Dhritya, the word is there in the Mula. Dhritya is Dheryena. That Dheriya is the steadfastness, the courage, the firmness. And therefore is Dhiraha. Dhiraha is intelligent. Dhiraha son, Bhiman son, being intelligent. He Nachiketa, O Nachiketas, Atyasrakshihi, which is there in the Moolam, it is explained, Param Eva Akankshan, Akankshan, desiring the Param, Param Eva Akankshan, Param Moksham Eva Akankshan, desiring only that which is permanent, what? Moksha, Atisrishtavanasi, you have given up everything. Sarvam Etat Bhogajatam, Samsara Bhogajatam, all these are Samsara Bhogajatam, which are all the pressures that they are Samsara Bhogajatam. All this, the Samsara Bhoga, the worldly pleasures, all the pleasures which are gained by this, nothing but worldly. So, Samsara Bhogajatam, Atyasrakshihi, Samsara Bhogajatam, which is the karma for Atyasrakshihi, Atisrishtavanasi. The karma for giving up is samsara bhoga jatam, that which is born of sukham, which is born of bhoga is sukham, pleasure. The pleasure born of all this, nothing but samsara. So samsara bhoga, samsara sukham. Samsara sukham, which is born of enjoying this, atisrishtavanasi, you are given up. Aho, ho, bata anuttama gunaha asi. Anuttama, what? Unsurpassable gunaha, the qualities, the characters you have. Aho, iti, Yamadambaraja, he praises. Aho, bata, anuttama gunaha, tum asi. You have anuttama guna, gunas which are not comparable. The gunas which are not there further to this. Gunaha na vidyate. There is no equivalent guna. You have, it means what? You have endowed excellent gunas, qualities. Therefore, anuttama gunaha, the word anuttama gunaha, it qualifies Nachiketa. It is anuttamaha gunaha yasya saha, bhagavrihi samasa. The one who has excellent qualities. Nachiketa, you are the one endowed with all these excellent qualities. I'm so happy with you and you have discarded even this Hiranyagarbha padavi. Iti Yamadharma Raja, he glorifies Nachiketa and therefore the vairagyam of Nachiketa. He has got tremendous vairagyam and that is praised by Nachiketa, showing that that is the most desirable quality of a sadhaka. This is what this mantra says. We can stop here. Rich mantra we will see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Dhanyavadah.
Dhanyavadah
Sharanji.
Yes. Dhanyavadah Sharanji.
Dhanyavadah
Ji. Salam.